Histology. It's a hard concept to grasp, but after watching this video and taking the time to practice, you're gonna be a pro. Let's start with the word histology. Histo means tissues. Ology means the study of. Wow. You should check out my song about the study of tissues and take a walk along the BM road. BM stands for basement membrane, but we'll talk about that a little bit later. Let's start from the beginning with the levels of organization. If you need a refresher, just click that link. We learned that humans are made up of cells and cells make up tissues. Today, we're going to learn about the four basic tissue types. We have epithelium, connective, nervous, and muscle. We're also going to learn how to identify and name each one. Let's start with epithelium. Look at these three pictures. What do all three of these pictures have in common? The two main things are that they both have cells on top of a thin sheet called the basement membrane. If you listen to my histology song, there's a part in the song that goes, I'm gonna learn these tissues on the BM road. I'm gonna learn them till I can't no more. Well, what that means is that all tissue cells sit on top of the basement membrane. And the basement membrane is the connector between the cells on top and the connective tissue underneath. So now that you know that all epithelial cells have a basement membrane, let's do three things together. First, determine the number of cell layers in the epithelium. Two, determine the shape of the cell layers. And three, combine the number of cell layers with the shape of the cell layers to name the epithelial tissue. Understanding these three steps is huge. Let's focus on how to number the cell layers first. Here we have simple and stratified.
Simple, single, stratified, multiple.
Simple has one cell layer, while stratified has multiple cell layers. To help me remember that stratified means multiple, I think of the game Jenga. In the game Jenga, you have to strategically place blocks on top of each other to build a tower. Stratified, multiple layers. Strategically place blocks to build multiple layers. Pretty easy, right? Well, now it's your turn. This picture represents stratified epithelium. True or false? If you said false, that is correct. Notice that there is only one layer of cells, and we learned that stratified means multiple. Remember, we build a tower by strategically placing blocks on top of each other. All right, now that you understand simple versus stratified, let's learn about how to determine the shape of the cells. There are three main categories when describing the shape: squamous, cuboidal, columnar. Thankfully, when we see the name of each category, we are given a hint as to what the shape of the cells are. For instance, squamous. Squamous cells look flat. I like to say that they look, oh my gosh, where is that coming from? This is really messing up my video right now. Anyways, I like to say that they look, squamous cells look flat or squashed, just like this mosquito. So let's say squamous cells are squashed and flat. Next, we have cuboidal. Cuboidal cells, well, they look like a cube. An ice cube, like the one from your Frieza, not the rapper, who in the movie says,
bye, Felicia.
Now that was cold. Get it? Like the ice cube? So let's remember that cuboidal cells look like a cube. This one, not that one. Lastly, we have columnar. Columnar cells look like a column. 2 years ago, I went to Greece and I was able to see some amazing architecture. The column is extremely prominent in ancient Greek architecture. So when I think of columnar tissue, it reminds me of the columns that I saw in Greece. I didn't get to travel anywhere this year, besides my backyard. So I guess my fence will be my columns this year. All right, it's time to wrap things up. We know how to number the cell layers, we know the shape, so it's time to name the epithelial tissue. I'm going to describe 6 epithelial tissues. Let's do it. Simple squamous, single flat and thin. This lines your lungs to help with filtration.
Since simple squamous epithelium has one layer and is flat, you will find this tissue where diffusion and filtration takes place. For example, your capillaries and alveoli.
Simple, single, cuboidal, a cube, you can find this tissue in the kidney tubules.
Simple cuboidal epithelium has one layer, is cube-shaped, and helps with secretion and absorption. You will find this tissue in the kidneys, pancreas, and salivary glands.
Simple columnar epithelium has microvilli or multiple cilium.
Simple columnar epithelium has one layer and long epithelial cells that resemble columns. Just like simple cuboidal epithelium, this tissue helps with secretion and absorption, but you will find ciliated columnar epithelium in the fallopian tubes and columnar epithelium with microvilli in the stomach and intestines.
Stratified squamous lines the epidermis, protects your skin from an abrasive surface.
Stratified squamous epithelium has multiple layers of cells that are flat, but not all of the layers may be flat. Since the cell type at the surface has squamous cells, we call it squamous epithelium, but the deeper layers can be columnar or cuboidal.
I consider the last two tissues to be the remix to simple and stratified epithelium. Pseudostratified epithelium appears to be stratified, but it's really simple epithelial tissue with nuclei at different levels. Pseudo means false. This tissue is covered in cilia, and it can be found in the nose, bronchi, or in the trachea. So, pseudostratified appears stratified, but it's one layer with nuclei, so don't believe that lie. The last tissue is a remix of stratified epithelium, and it's called transitional. It's different from other stratified epithelium because this one stretches. We can find this tissue in the bladder, so leaky bladder.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
So transitional tissue, it hits my back. Remember, practice is key to learning all the different types of epithelial tissue. If you need a little bit more practice, check the description box below for some really helpful websites. Let's move on to connective tissue. Connective tissue is divided into loose and dense connective tissue, cartilage, blood, bone, and adipose tissue. We're gonna focus on these 4 types. First up is cartilage. Cartilage has chondrocytes. Chondro means cartilage, cyte means cell. Cartilage is also avascular. That means cartilage has no blood vessels. Check this out. Notice that cartilage injuries take the longest to heal. That's due to cartilage being avascular. There are 3 types of cartilage found in the body. You have fibrocartilage, hyaline cartilage, and elastic cartilage. Next up, we have blood. You may be thinking, blood is a liquid. How can it be a connective tissue? Well, blood has the characteristics of connective tissue. Let's look at this one specifically. It has a liquid matrix called plasma. Let's briefly discuss the word matrix. More importantly, extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix is non-living intercellular material that surrounds the cells of a tissue. So we just wrapped up epithelium. Epithelium has a matrix, but not a lot, because epithelial cells are bound together into sheets called epithelia. The extracellular matrix is made of basal lamina. Basal lamina is a part of the basement membrane. And we learned that the basement membrane is the connector between the epithelial cells and the connective tissue. Now, on the other hand, connective tissue has a lot of extracellular matrix, and it's filled with protein fibers. So what's the takeaway? Epithelial cells, less matrix, more cells. Connective tissue, less cells, more matrix. The matrix is so important because it determines the tissue's structure and function. Notice that cartilage has a solid matrix and no blood vessels. Blood has a liquid matrix called plasma, and the third connective tissue on our list, bone, has a solid matrix like cartilage, but it's vascular, meaning that bone has a blood supply. So can a broken bone injury result in bleeding? Yup, because bone is vascular. Not only does bone have a solid matrix and blood vessels, but it has osteocytes. Osteo means bone. Site means cell. The bone also has osteons. The osteons make the bone one of the easier connective tissues to identify. The osteons remind me of rings in a tree trunk cross section. A tree trunk provides support for the tree, and our bones provide support for our body. The last connective tissue on our list is adipose, the fat. Adipose has adipocytes. Adipo means fat, site means cells, and adipocytes are filled with lipids, which we learned in the biochemistry lecture is fat. Notice that the adipocyte is so filled with fat that it even moves the nucleus out of the way. That's messed up. All right, two down, two more to go. Next up is nervous tissue. What was that? My heart is beating out of my chest. My stomach hurts. When you and I get scared, signals are sent to our brain by cells in nervous tissue called neurons. Neurons are nerve cells. Nervous tissue is made up of neurons and neuroglia. We will talk more about neuroglia in the nervous system lecture. I'm gonna go catch my breath. We have now reached our final tissue type for the day, muscle tissue. There are three types: skeletal, smooth, and cardiac. You know what? When I got scared by that, whatever that was, all three muscle types were actually at work. Look at this. After I got scared, I moved my hands to my heart, and then I moved my hands to my stomach. That was due to skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle is attached to my bones and controls voluntary movement. Under the microscope, notice that cells are vertical, striated, and multinucleated, which means they have many nuclei. When I got scared, I didn't tell my heart to beat faster. As a matter of fact, I don't have to tell my heart to beat at all because cardiac muscle, which is found in the walls of the heart, is under involuntary control. Cardi, this one, not that one, means heart. So cardiac muscle is only found in the heart. Under the microscope, notice that it's striated like skeletal muscle, but cardiac muscle's key feature is that it has intercalated discs. These are only found in cardiac muscle. The last thing that happened when I got scared is that my stomach started to hurt. That was due to smooth muscle that lines the walls of the stomach. I didn't have any control over that happening, so smooth muscle is under involuntary control, just like cardiac muscle. Not only is smooth muscle found in the walls of the stomach, but it's also found in the intestines and your blood vessels. Under the microscope, notice that there are no striations. That's why it's called smooth muscle. The cells are also flat and stretched out. Wow, we've covered a lot. We talked about epithelial tissue, connective tissue, nervous tissue, and muscle tissue. Make sure you check the description box below. I have links to some really great websites that can assist you as you continue studying histology. I hope this helps, and I'll see you soon. Science G, signing out.